Tattooing for permanent eyebrows, lips and eyeliner is a beauty trend that is definitely on the rise.
But it's unregulated. Some practitioners are setting up shop after just a two-day course, and botched jobs are becoming increasingly common. Take a look.
Oh, wow. Catherine McCann is a cosmetic and medical tattooist, and she specialises in repairing the work of others. And she joins us now from Brisbane, along with Narelle Walker, who turned to Catherine after her own procedure went awry. Ladies, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Catherine, we might start with you. What is cosmetic tattooing exactly? And what sort of things are people getting done? We've heard about eyebrows. It's something that I've had done before. But what other things are people having done?
Thank you. Good morning to you both. Cosmetic tattooing is obviously a tattoo. So it incorporates a large sort of area of things. Most popularly, people know really about eyebrows, they know about eyeliner and lips. But it also sort of expands to incorporate things like medical tattooing. So camouflage, scars, restoration or covering up and concealing from accident and injury. But then there's also another aspect which I suppose takes up quite a large number of a large amount of time in my clinic, and that's the botched work. So it's the restorative, it's fixing up tattoos which have been, I guess, less than satisfactory or in some cases really quite botched.
Yeah, like we saw in that video before. Yeah. Wow, those eyebrows were nowhere near the original.
And Narelle, tell us how you sought out Catherine, because you've had a bad experience.
Yes, I think half those lovely photos were of me, but I ended up looking, thought I did my due diligence to get my eyebrows done, and I was speaking with friends in my circle and just said, what do I do? You know, this looks terrible. And I went to one of my friends, cosmetic tattooist, and she just said, look, this is out of my wheelhouse. You know, you need to see Kat. She's the queen of, you know, botched cosmetic tattooing on the coast. So off I went and saw Kat, and she was just amazing, you know, took the time to, you know, talk me through, you know, if it could be done, what could be done, how long it would take and all that sort of thing. It was just a wonderful experience going to Kat, and, you know, she made me feel great because I certainly wasn't feeling great at the time.
We've seen that some people can set up shop after only doing a two-day course. We've seen from TikTok videos that some people are having their friends do this cosmetic tattooing. And not only is it an aesthetic issue, it can also lead to infection and serious scarring. So, Catherine, how did you then repair Narelle's tattoo, and how long did that take? Because that ink is permanent, right?
Yes, definitely. And quite often mistakes are... they will last a lot longer than what they were, I suppose, ever intended to. So Narelle came to me, and like all of my clients, because obviously there's no two faces that are the same. So she came in, we did a consultation, and I guess I just listened to her concerns. We talked about what brought her to me, what sort of, you know, experience she had had, and then we were able to sort of unpack and then have a look at what the next steps would be. So in Narelle's case, she felt that the brows that she had tattooed were probably the wrong shape for her face. They made her feel like she'd almost had a mono brow. And then obviously they were a little bit uneven and patchy. So we ended up doing non-laser removal. So we did two sessions of that with significant healing time in between, because like any correction or removal, there are downtime. Then once that sort of went through that proper healing process, we were able to sort of assess on each subsequent visit when she came in. And then fortunately, Narelle was very patient as well. We were able to then re-tattoo the brows because we could maintain the integrity of the skin through that whole process.
Ooh, was that painful for you, Narelle?
No, one of the things that's great about Kat is she is so thorough. So she has a compounding chemist, and she makes you then see them, where you go through a survey with them and they make your own numbing cream that's suitable for your skin and face. So, you know, it makes it, you know, a lot more comfortable which is great.
Well, it's great to see you smiling now. You look wonderful. Yeah. Catherine, are there any jobs or are there any home jobs or have there been botches that you've just looked at and you just can't fix or you just can't help them?
Absolutely. Yeah, I think they come from all sort of different angles. Primarily, I mean, you can have people that go overseas and they have different treatments and things done and then obviously come back to Australia. Botched jobs range from really quite severe to quite sort of main, like easy to fix, I suppose. And so basically, depending on what type of case walks through the door, it will also then mean you're able to sort of come up with a different plan. So people that we can't obviously restore or treat, and you know, factors that would limit that would be potentially a person's age, how well they are, what the sort of integrity of their skin is like. So obviously we want to be able to maintain that and then keep them nice and healthy throughout that whole process. But other factors are things like the location of the tattoo, where it sits in the skin, how old it is, the level of saturation, heaps of those things. And I think also managing expectations is a really important factor, simply because what we can do and what we can't do are quite sort of unpredictable, potentially when you're working with previously compromised skin.
We said at the start of the interview that this is an industry that is unregulated, and Narelle said that she thought she'd done her due diligence. So then what sort of questions should we be asking or should people be asking if they'd like to visit a cosmetic tattooist? Because obviously there's some benefits that can be gained from these people as well.
Definitely. Look, I think at the end of the day, everybody sort of says, look, do your research, and that's great advice. However, most of the time, a lot of people come and say, well, what sort of questions do I ask? And even knowing where to start or the types of questions, I think primarily are what people need to sort of, I guess, need to know so that they can begin to peel back that onion. But what I've done is I've put together probably my top five tips. And so they would be things like, do your research, but you want to find an artist who you love their style, because essentially you're buying their skill set to implant pigment into your skin. Mm. You also want to compare artists, have a look at their healed work versus their fresh work, and then make sure that you're comparing apples to apples. So essentially, if you are a mature aged client that has minimal hair and you're wanting a type of style, find an artist that does that and then get their photos healed and then compare them to what you would have, because that's going to give you a really good idea of what you're going to come out with at the end. Also, book a consultation, because this is your opportunity to meet the therapist or meet a technician, ask those sorts of questions, and use it as a reverse interview, because again, at the end of the day, they're going to walk out, so you want to walk out and know what the process looks like.
Absolutely.
But you also want to be comfortable that you're able to work through that process, particularly when you're looking at doing botched restorations.
All of that is such good advice. Ladies, thank you so much for your time today. And thank you as well, Narelle, for sharing your story. Really
thank
appreciate
you.
It.